I grew up as a big sports fan, as I think many people are. When I was going to school, I thought I would either be a doctor, my dad's a doctor, or a football coach, because my grandpa was a football coach. And about halfway through my time, I realized that I loved football too much. I couldn't move away from it, so got a job coaching football after I graduated and was doing that, and then had an opportunity to join the staff here at UVA in an analyst role, and decided to combine those into kind of the current role of football analytics here at UVA. So my role as Director of Football Analytics is to get our coaches actionable information that helps them make decisions quickly, efficiently, and help to increase our team's chances to win. So we're in meetings pretty early in the morning, getting ready for practices. Then we practice in the morning here. So when I'm out at practice, I'm gathering information so we can go through that, look at how practice went. During the game, I'm on a headset and talk to our coaches to help them as big decisions happen, whether it's a decision on fourth down or a decision of when to go for it, or versus kicking a PAT after we score a touchdown. And so that is kind of real-time discussion in the game. During the off season, I do have a little bit more time to do deeper dive projects and spend a little bit more time, you know, investigating different ideas that I think might be beneficial. Okay, one of the projects I recently did was a project on penalties and how they affect the game and how they affect our team. So I went, looked around for some data on penalties and was able to get it through an API of a company that we use their data. So read that data in and then do some, you know, exploratory data analysis, looking at what the data actually says. So this was our penalties kind of year over year feel. You know, here, hopefully this visualization is easy to read. That's a goal for any visualization that I create, is our coaches don't have a lot of time to kind of dive through a ton of numbers and a ton of data. So if I can clean things up and make it easy to read and easy to get a feel for quickly, then I feel like I've done a good job there. So you can see, you know, we're one of the least penalized teams, you know, well below the ACC average most times. But you get a feel of you can see the teams here, you know, not Clemson's obviously been really good, ACC champs for a couple years. They're pretty low, so you'd feel good about that. But, you know, North Carolina was really good last year. Miami was really good last year. You know, I think you get a feel for teams that are high penalty. You know, sometimes that can be, you know, disadvantage or not good for your team. And so I was able to kind of run through this and get a feel for how we did as an offense and a defense. It gives us an opportunity to really dive into and scout ourselves with what we're doing, especially in practice, so that we can get a feel to put our best, you know, product out in the field and give our guys the best chance to win when we play our games during the fall season. In coaching and in sports, so many decisions are based on what numbers say. Data science can help not only get those numbers more efficiently, but find better stats, better numbers, better things to base your information and your decisions on. There are also opportunities to get involved. A great thing about being in school is that there are a lot of teams at that university. You know, there are a few things that are happening here specifically at UVA. You know, the data science school has initiatives trying to increase the scope and vision of sports analytics. But I think that there's a lot going on kind of anywhere where people can get involved to a higher degree.